Okay, we're back on day two in Nagua's kitchen. Hi, Nagua.
Hi.
What's on the menu this evening?
Today we have mashi.
Okay, mashi.
This is Egyptian food. Mm-hmm. It's mashi, the word mashi in Arabic means stuffed.
Okay.
Stuffed, something that is stuffed. So we're going to have rolled cabbage.
Mm-hmm.
The cabbage, we cut it in a right size, and we put this there and we roll it.
Mm.
This thing has everything you can think of.
What's in there?
Onion, rice, mm-hmm. tomatoes, green parsley, green coriander, powder coriander, powder cumin, mm-hmm. and all the spices, and what else? Red chili, mm-hmm. a little bit.
Yeah. But Nagua, I noticed something.
Yes.
Last night when you were cooking, you were using your fingers, pinching this and pinching that.
Yes, I do.
You know, why do you do that?
I don't feel okay with using the spoon.
Oh.
I feel like I'm not cooking.
Oh.
So
where did you learn to cook? Where did you learn to do this kind of cooking?
I also have the sense of the amount.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah,
she can exactly know how much.
If I hold it with my hands, it feels
right.
So she would have the sense of the amount.
So it's a body thing.
It's a body thing. I like the touching it.
And talk about your mom and the women in your family. Did they cook the same way?
The same thing. Same way. Same way. I only see the spoon thing on TV.
You know, me too. In the village, I come from Buxton, as you know. In the village, we learned from our parents. They just kind of heft it, you know, like use it in their, put the ingredients in their hand, and they would kind of like weigh it. They say like heft it, and then they throw it inside.
Exactly.
Or they eyeball it, they say.
Exactly.
Right.
As soon as you start measuring that, until that time, I should be a chemical engineer, and I should tell my students, oh, be careful with the amount.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe it's a good cook sign
mm-hmm.
that if you do it with your body sense,
yeah. mm-hmm.
you're already there, you're a veteran.
Right.
Maybe this we won't have this feeling. Maybe
yes.
when you're mm-hmm. you're a beginner cook, you don't if you do the spoon thing and the measuring, she's new to this world.
I see. So this is the Egyptian way. And let me tell you, the Egyptian way is no different from the Guyanese, Caribbean, Buxtonian, village woman's way, or even man's way, because men cook too, and they know how to, you know, mix stuff and put the right ingredients. So I'm happy to see this. And so there's no meat in there, right?
No meat, but you can put meat. Some
okay.
people, we will use them. Today we have a whole chicken.
Mm-hmm. Let me see that whole chicken. Oh la la, the whole bird is in the pot.
So actually this is a special chicken because
mm-hmm.
it's raised in Japan.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and
it's got the Japanese passport chicken.
Yeah. Yeah, because you know, usually chicken are from Brazil, you know?
I see.
And Brazilian chicken is very...
No offense. No offense.
No offense, okay.
So your preference
chicken,
is not Japanese?
Brazilian chicken is very good.
You prefer not to eat that chicken, right? You prefer to eat this one. This one doesn't have passport, right?
No, the only difference is this is fish, but Brazilian is not fish.
No, it's not like
okay.
we're not racist on this, but this one maybe mm-hmm. eat different food.
I see.
It shows on the taste of the meat.
Okay. Well, what's this one eating?
I think it eats fresh, not fresh green stuff.
Green plants, yeah.
We have this in Egypt. We have at home, even when we get one from the farm,
mm-hmm.
we leave them at the houses, the backyard.
Yes.
For a few, and the name for this is that clean it.
Mm-hmm.
It eat our food.
And get itself clean.
Yes, so that we can actually
right.
eat from that and mm-hmm. taste good.
But you know, Nagua, when I was growing up, we used to have what we call yard fowl. Yard fowl, yard is like the space outside of your house. Where you be in your fence, and
yes.
the chickens used to run wild there. They call it free range nowadays. fancy name, but basically
yeah.
it was a yard, follow a yardie.
Yeah.
And your parents used to catch one, kill it, fix
yes.
it up, and it's in a pot. Tastes so good.
I know. So
yeah.
I can't forget this taste because When if you were in rush and you get the chicken right away from the farm, the intensive farm phase, it doesn't taste as good. If you have to eat it right away, we know the difference.
Right. So okay. So we're going to leave you here on pause. We'll come back to look at this good chicken.
So, and today you have also stuffed
peppers.
Pepper.
Okay, good. So I'm going to go out for a little bit, see what the neighborhood has to offer. In the evening, I checked it out at 4 o'clock this morning. So I'm going to check it out this evening and I'll get back to you.
Good.
All right, thanks. Happy cooking.
You too. Thanks a lot.
This is on the other side of Nagla's building. Another garden. What drew me to this garden is the presence of all these pet bottles or soda bottles. On first glance, I thought that these soda bottles were cut on the bottom and used for, you know, seedlings or something. Maybe they had seedlings in there somehow. But the closer I looked, I realized this was really a homemade greenhouse. So they planted the seedlings in the ground and then cut the pet bottles on the bottom, stuck them over the little seedlings to protect them from the birds. Because like I told you, these crows are vicious. They would tear up anything. This is an ingenious way of planting. I gotta copy this. I've never seen this in my village. But Japanese are very clever people and very innovative. So I always have an eye for looking out for what's innovative. What I like about Japan too is that the edibles are right beside the flowers. So they will have a little bit of flower bushes in one corner or a little bed, and right beside it you have string beans. I think these are, not string beans, they're butter beans or snap beans. And on the same arbor, they have cucumbers. I don't see any cucumbers, but the bloom is on, so I'm sure fruit is going to come there soon. And when you go into supermarkets, you can find these little flowers. You can buy bunches of them. So this is where they grow, right beside the eggplant and right beside the onions and the lilies. Isn't this awesome? So you can get the pollination going. So you just don't have to have just greens or veggies. You can have everything. And right over here, I think these are green onions or regular onions. I can't be sure. I think they're green onions. But we have lettuce and I think these are soybeans or edamame. I think, yeah, that's right. Planted right beside it. To the back, I think those are tomatoes. They strung them up and they have greenhouses. And look at this. Just beside the modern houses is a rice field. People, you don't have to have an acre of land to have a rice field. The Japanese know how to do it. And look at the parking spot. News. There are no parking of cars in the street here. It's illegal. First of all, to get a driver's license or to buy a car, not a driver's license, to buy a car, you have to have proof of parking. You have to have a place to park it and the proof. But the fascinating thing is that rice field beside the house. Yes, I remember in the village, there's a time when people planted rice right in their drains to get the paddy to feed their chickens. So it's not unheard of. Again, the streets are so clean. I've seen little old ladies come out in the morning with brooms and sweep the streets. Yeah, the street belonged to the community. So they clean the streets themselves with brooms and the little, you know, dust holder or the dust pan. These people have bent double and they will sweep the streets. What a community effort. I think this should be applauded. I'm really amazed and I feel privileged to live here, to expand my world and see how things are done. So, enjoy.
Beautiful. Just a little bit bigger when it was cooking. Got tired a little bit. I think you can see. Fulfill. Mashi. Crop. I'm speaking Arabic, so roasted, boiled roasted chicken, mahshi, rolled cabbage with rice and stuffed green pepper and salad and hummus. And I put in bread. And
Bulukhaya,
I'm gonna heat the bread and so in the oven toaster, so it's gonna blow. So the kitchen doesn't look very best, but how much I'm gonna make?